Let us study an important factor related to binding energy per nucleon, that is binding energy per nucleon as a stability criteria. This we will understand with the help of an example. If we consider two nuclei of iron 56 and bismuth 209, then binding energy of these nuclei are, binding energy of iron nuclei is 492.8 million electron volt and binding energy of bismuth is 1640 million electron volt. And here if we just have a look on the two, we can see that when iron nucleus is formed, then 492.8 MeV energy is released, and at the time of formation of bismuth nucleus, 1640 MeV is released. So it appears that bismuth is more stable compared to iron, because to split the bismuth nucleus into its constituents, more energy is required. But if we just have a look on binding energy per nucleon of these two nuclei, this binding energy per nucleon for iron, this will be 492.8 divided by 56, because number of nucleon in iron is 56. If we calculate, this will be 8.8 MeV. And similarly, if we calculate binding energy per nucleon for bismuth nuclei, then it is 1640 divided by 209. Then the value will be 7.84 MeV. And here you can see, removal of one nucleon from the nucleus of iron requires 8.8 million electron volt, and that from bismuth requires 7.84 million electron volt. So here we can write, removal of one nucleon from iron nucleus requires more energy than bismuth. So iron is more stable nuclei. So this is the way how we can compare this binding energy per nucleon as a better criteria to judge nuclear stability. And here we can say, as bismuth is a heavy as well as large size nucleus, that's why it releases more energy at the time of bounding all the nucleons. But in case of iron, per nucleon binding energy is much more compared to any other atom. This is the reason why iron is considered to be the most stable nucleus in the whole periodic table.